So, it's that time of year again, and as you know, Inktober has begun. And I'm not saying that I'm not going to do Inktober, but I am doing Inktober. You guys won't see it because YouTube, and I don't have a camera that is sustained, and my workspace is, it's good for my size. I'm 6'5", 300 plus, I'm fat, and the idea of going in this little corner with a camera is just not the ideal. You see me working on the commission in the background, but nonetheless, I'm not going to be doing Inktober. Well, what am I talking about? I am, I'm sorry, I'm very tired. I got my wisdom teeth pulled, and it gave me some really strong medication, and now I might sound a little bit loopy, but I'm not. I know that Inktober is something you're supposed to do every day with some type of pen. And to be honest, it doesn't matter what kind of pen. You can go to Dollar Tree. I'm literally doing mine with ballpoint pens and Micron pens, and that's, and the only reason I'm doing them with Micron pens is because I had them. But every time I do Inktober, I would go to Dollar Tree and just get some ballpoint pens. Because it's, I mean, to not to be wrong, these little Dollar Tree pens are not bad. I enjoy my little Dollar Tree pens, but very different from 6 years ago when I first started drawing. I mean, I get commissions and I do stuff where it has to look different, and ballpoint ink doesn't like stick the way it's supposed to. So, yeah, you know, it's something by John Jake Parker is his name. Yeah, he's like a professional inker, you know, or cartoonist. I forgot. Again, I'm sorry. I'm very tired when I record this. But nonetheless, he's a professional inker and, I'm sorry, a professional cartoonist. And he does these videos where he talks about, you know, cartooning and inking sometimes and stuff. He has a lot of good advice up there too. But, I mean, you're drawing with pencil, then going over with ink. There's an official prompt list that I did not put up here while I'm recording this, but when I'm done recording this narration, I'll put that at the very end. Yeah, so there's a prompt list, and today will be the day that, it's the second one today, so it'll be divided. And what I plan to do is record a YouTube video of all my Inktober drawings at the very end, however many I end up doing, and I'm gonna paint them with watercolor, and I plan to do that at the very end of the month. And yeah, that's honestly it. I don't know, controversial topics, Inktober with digital art, it doesn't matter. Your inking is inking. You know, you can ink with pencil, to be quite frank. The idea of using a pen is just being able to not go back and fix your mistakes and learn to love your mistakes. But you can see, I'm more of a digital artist now because of the convenience. I can take it places and actually participate in things better. And the program I use has a whole brush set for Inktober brushes and stuff. And you know, I'm not, no, you don't have to do this traditionally. But I think for me, because I've done digital art so much, I would like to go back and practice traditional. I'm doing it for practice sake, but you don't have to do this traditionally. It's a choice. I mean, it's crazy. You ink whenever you're darkening a line over a line that's already there. I mean, I don't think I do it that much in this picture. I'm doing this how I draw in paper, to be honest, just draw the head. And there was more of this picture. There's more of this draw in the beginning, but the file got corrupted. And you're seeing recording through a video player because the file that OBS saves in is not MP4, it's like a VLS or something like that. So, yeah. More importantly, well, back on the topic, I apologize, I digress. Yeah, Inktober is something supposed to be fun. You don't even have to follow the rules. It's just something that promotes you to draw every day. Some people are doing Goretober. Some people are having their own little prompts. I've seen Christian artists have their own prompts for, you know, biblical references and stuff like that. And that's perfectly fine. It's something to make you draw every day and help hone your skills and practice. You do not have to follow those prompts. But, I mean, for somebody, for me, who has to, like, search through things on Pinterest, Tumblr, Twitter, Facebook to even get some inspiration, have to go into all these tags. Inktober is good for me because it tells me what to draw. And although I do have commissions I need to do, therefore Inktober will not be getting 104% you know, participation as it should. You know, this is a little cartoon I'm doing for somebody right now who requested it, and he was like, you know what, we're neighbors, I'll pay you for it. And I was thinking, chuckle, chuckle, you were going to pay anyway. But nonetheless, I think that is cool. And I think that's a good idea to Inktober, to do Inktober. I apologize. I think that it will help you develop your skills a lot. And it's appropriate. You got to practice if you want to get good at art. I'm not that good at art, honestly. But I think that it's very appropriate that people practice their art and as often as possible to continue to get better. How do you get to Carnegie Hall? Practice. I think Holly Brown did a better job at saying this, but you don't have to. You don't have to do traditional inking for Inktober. That idea, it's not even that it's out of date, it's just unnecessary. You're drawing, it's like the same argument that we have between digital and traditional. My artwork doesn't look that different on my traditional stuff than my digital. I mean, that's not true. I do my cartoony stuff traditionally. That's because I like drawing the cartoony stuff on paper and the realistic stuff up here. And I have to do realistic stuff. I have a new sketchbook dedicated to doing realism and watercolor. So, yeah, let's just not pretend it's not an argument, but let's have it for argument's sake to say, hey, let's have a better way to have this conversation. You know, like, one argument with the traditional versus digital is that the computer does all the work for you. I know you all see me sketching in this effing face. Like, you see what I'm saying? It's a completely different argument. Yes, there are shortcuts. I mean, the amount of work is similar. And if it's cut back minutely, like, I know you can't change colors like this. I know you can't do it on paper, and if you mess up, that's it. But that's just one of the perks of doing digital art. And that's okay. I know you can't do a color move and a hue and saturation change. And I'm fully aware of that. And I'm fully aware of how dumb I was when I was drawing this, that I already felt I had that color in there. I just didn't pay attention. But that's okay. That's okay. Nonetheless, it's just important to know that even if you're not drawing the way that everybody else wants you to, that you enjoy what you're doing. It is perfectly fine to do Inktober on digital. Heck, you don't have to buy special supplies to do this challenge, okay? You can do this challenge in your room, on the floor, upside down, on your ceiling, whatever. The biggest thing is to just have fun while you're doing it. You know, you're not going to be, you know, you may be the very best artist on the planet, but you're going to want to have fun. Have fun doing it. Have fun practicing. Have fun drawing. It's art. It's what we live. It's what we breathe. It's a beautiful thing that we do. Don't get too caught up in the hype about, oh, you shouldn't be doing it on digital. You should do it traditional. Just draw. But, I mean, I understand the rules have their reason to make things difficult and make it a challenge, but not everybody can dedicate to that. I'm a full-time student. I do commission work, and I'm a mathematics major. I don't have time to do Inktober every single day. And if I do, thank God, blessed be the Lord, our highest and greatest, because this is hard. It's hard to keep up with. To draw a full picture every single day in ink. While this is recording, I'm inking something for day. I'm starting to do a little sketch for day 3, and I know that's cheating, but I'm not crazy. Want to do something every day? I am. It's almost midnight over here. So that means, yeah. And I'm recording it after I've already edited the video, so I'm not just talking over it while I was finishing the drawing that somewhat might be almost done. So that's what makes it crazy. All in all, without a doubt, you gotta enjoy what you're doing, and if you don't enjoy it, you're not gonna be able to do it. I'm assuming that people who are doing this that love art or just want to practice. It's a good way to show off, though. You can practice and love your art at the same time while doing this challenge, and it will help you grow, it will help you develop, you'll learn so much. You'll understand what it is to be focused. You'll understand time constraints. It'll help you sketch faster. And you know what? I refuse to do the Sketchbook Slam Challenge. This is the closest thing to it. So you need to understand that this is a challenge for fun. I'm not trying to knock Jake Parker for his rules. I think the rules are very understanding. But not everybody's going to fall into it. You can enjoy this or you won't. Or you will. Whichever one you end up doing, it's all the way up to you. But, you know, just have fun. I know that we're all caught up in the, I know that I should just do what the rules say and whatever, but if you don't follow them, who's going to kill you for it? You know what I'm saying? But more importantly, again, just have fun. This is not supposed to be something that stresses you out. You're supposed to go and enjoy it and have fun with it. So make it that. Don't get caught up in all these rules. I'm doing it the way that it's set because I've never done it like that before. And to me, it's just something new. So without a doubt, like I always believe in saying, have fun with your art. And don't feel bad if they're like, oh my goodness, you're not doing the way you're supposed to. Bump that. You do it the way you want to. Have fun with this hard challenge because it's hard. There's no real rules. But like I said, be happy. Enjoy. Stay up.